Pattison's arts programmer and the curator of Contacting Toronto. We're in this together. Ladies and gentlemen, Sharon Switzer.
Thank you very much, Michael. As Michael said, I'm the arts programmer and curator for Pattison One Stop. I'm also the director of Art for Commuters, and I curated one of the four exhibitions that we have up this year for Contact. Pattison is very proud to be involved in four installations, helping to bring an unprecedented audience to this very well-respected photography festival. A special project for Contact, Public Spaces, Private Thoughts by Derek Besant, is presented on 25 subway platforms, a total of 100 posters. The portraits echo the unending flow of people one encounters in the subway while waiting for a train and the secrets we share in common. The exhibition that I curated is an official public installation for Contact. This is the sixth year that we've been doing this project with Contact, and we are proud to be expanding it this year. This year it's a two-part exhibition created especially for the TTC that makes strategic use of both Pattison subway platform posters and the network of Pattison One Stop LCD screens. We're in this together transforms this public space and the commuter experience by balancing the live presentation of digital images, which have been selected from a broad open call to all Torontonians on Flickr, with a curated selection of poster-sized photographs in 60 stations. The six photographers whose work takes up the discussion of what it's like to live in Toronto are Alyssa Bestoneth, Aaron Vincent Elkame, Deborah Friedman, Ruth Kaplan, Brent Lewin, and Robert Poulton. And we have, I think, three of those artists here with us today. So the public call, also addressing the theme, we're in this together, in terms of living together in Toronto, plays once every 5 minutes on 300 screens across the network, and also on dedicated art zone screens in three downtown stations for the first week of Contact. So none of the regular news or ads play on those screens. It's just Contact content. And one of those dedicated screens is right here at Dundas Station. The others are at Bloor and St. Andrews stations. So I'm very pleased to be able to use the TTC as a vehicle for a public dialogue about our city. I also want to thank the Ontario Arts Council for supporting this project. Above ground, on Pattison outdoor billboards in Toronto, and six cities across Canada, Tim Hetherington's portraits of sleeping American soldiers tell a timeless story about the lives of men in war zones. Also presented on Pattison outdoor billboards at Spadina Avenue and Front Street is Jim Goldberg's ongoing project about displaced Western peoples who hope to make a better life for themselves in, displaced peoples who hope to make a better life for themselves in Western Europe. But now I'm going to introduce Jane Noakes, who will speak about Derek Besant's project, as Derek's not available to be with us. Jane is the director of Scotiabank Group's Corporate Archives and Fine Art Collection. Under Noakes' direction, the SGA and FA portfolio has grown to influence sponsorship in the arts, culture, and heritage. Her most recent initiative is the Scotiabank Photography Award, the SPA, which she developed in 2010 to be the largest annual peer-reviewed celebration of excellence in Canadian contemporary photography.
Jane, it's really a privilege and a pleasure. We opened the Contact Festival on Friday night for any of you who have a good time at Mocha and have the bags under your eyes to prove it still. We had a good party on Friday night. Derek is really sorry that he can't be here. Part of me says, yes, yeah, sure, you're in Mexico, but I know he really, really would like to be here for the beginning of Contact, especially because pulling this together, as you can imagine, was no mean feat. When an artist starts with a bunch of admirers and a fan and a sponsor to pull something together as big as this project, it really makes a big difference. And it's made a difference in his life, which is a life of moving parts. He moves around the world constantly with his exhibitions, probably more well known outside Canada than inside Canada at this stage, but today, at least with us, we're going to know a bit better inside Canada. Derek is a world-class artist. He is a professor at the Alberta College of Art and Design, has been for years. He's embraced the technological advances that were presented to him through his association with Pattison from the late 1980s. His photo-based art projects, many of them incorporate music, a lot of them incorporate text and dialogue. Right, Randy? Dialogue, yeah. Are currently on display all across the world. I met Derek in 1976 when I arrived in Calgary to install the very first acquisitions of the Scotiabank Fine Art Collection in Calgary's Scotia Center. And as my husband says, we finish each other's sentences and have ever since. He also says, what plot are you and Derek cooking up now? And the answer to that in the late 80s was what became Waterfall, the mural in Scotia Plaza, for any of you who have been there. That 69 8 by 10 foot panels. So imagine trying to paint those all at once. And Derek, trying to imagine doing that, ended up walking into the office of Randy Otto, and the rest is history. From there on, Derek and Randy have been friends. Randy and I have become friends. Derek has just loved everything that he learns about silkscreen, about the various technological advances that the outdoor billboard sign community take for granted. He turns them into something that is much more artistic, I would suggest. The Waterfall mural is the largest indoor mural in Canada, but it was his second iconic mural in Toronto. For those of you who have the answer to this one, you can get a sucker. No. It's the Flatiron Building, that great proscenium that has stood the test of time. And is still a tourist attraction, as is Waterfall. Waterfall gets written up in New York art magazines 20 some odd years after it was installed. Randy and I have been longtime collaborators of Derek. We were voices, the English-speaking voices, on 15 Restless Nights. That was unveiled at Harbourfront during the first Scotiabank Week launch in 2006. 15 Restless Nights is created on silkscreen with techniques Derek learned at Pattison, and it's traveled the world ever since. It will return to Derek's home base of Calgary later this year for the first ever to weave launch in Calgary, which I think is really a nice touch. It will also be featured in Paris, the place that invented Nuit Blanches, at the Canadian Cultural Centre this year, which I also think is a very nice touch. Derek and I have been linked on a number of projects along with Scotiabank for a number of years. Most recently on Broken Ground. Derek's project, Broken Ground, will show in Shanghai, one of the few North American solo artists, and his Eye on the River project in Calgary that Pattison also sponsored. Derek really is a visionary. He's intellectually curious. He's emotionally engaged in every aspect of his world, and he's artistically talented. So he brings every facet to bear, I think, on this project. The result is a rare treat for the Toronto audience. It's an exhibition by an art luminary. It's all displayed in 100 sites in 25 subway stations for the full month of May. All free, all accessible, all brought to you through the collaboration of Contact, of the TTC, and of Derek's admirers, all through the generous support of Pattison Outdoor. Thanks very much.